This is an example of the inventory monitoring application. In the first table, I import the data from the Excel file. I will show you the Excel file that I made.
If you have the Excel file, and then you can write a program in order to generate the user interface like this, right? Easily, right? By using Mathematica, right?
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you show also show us about the program as well?
Yes. Yeah, it's my Excel file that I contain some data in for the inventory management. The first column is date and the second column is product. I use the product ID to for this table. It's easy to record them to the ID than the string. And this is a beginning inventory and the demand and expire is the number the quantity of the product that is expired. Then is order no orders to order the product. And the other quantity that the user will enter when the order is needed. And when it will be more than zero when the product is arrived. And the ending inventory, the ending inventory will come from can be calculated by the beginning inventory subtract by demand subtract expire and plus other unit received. And I create another table that is to show the product details. The first column is ID and is linked by the product name. And then cost, that is the unit cost for cost and then it's price. And the last one, I create the list detail. For the receipt, I use the receipt ID to indicate the like an invoice of the product to show that there is product on each day, anything else, and product ID that is linked with the product details table. And this quantity is the quantity for receive. The receive and then expiration date. Come back to the program. The first table I will import from the log table. And expiration date I import from the receive table. And if I want to update sausage, the new date will be at and the event the inventory will be calculated. When I press F button, the data will be changed, but the file in the Excel will not change because I not create the save file. And your friend asked me, can you show type of cell on the chart? Actually, the load data function and for the type of the data in the Excel, you can ignore them because when you import from Excel, it can cast the type of the data into the data appropriately. You can see this data compared with the history log Excel. You can see that the date, this is the date format, and it will be cast to the date object and product. When it will be number, it will be cast to the real number here. And if it has to take the text format, it will convert to be the screen in the Mass America. You can see that when you import the date format from the Excel in the Mass America, it will be converted to the date. Object, this is the object. You can use the string. I will show you this is the object. You can use the string. The string will convert the date object to be the string. And you can give them the format of them by can use the string and give them the format by using the sequence of the string like this. then you can create the date object by using the date object. And use the date object. You can use the date object and give them give this function by take the parameter of this function by years, months, and day respectively. Moreover, you can calculate the date by using the date plus can using date plus. Date plus will be received the date object, and then if you want to add two more days, you can space to you can enter to and you change to to stay at the name. And you transform the thing into the object format. If you put the string from the date object, it will return the date object. But if we want running the interpretation of the string will be ambiguous. But I think it can be used. The date object. For the date object in the MathMaker, it starts with month, and then day and then year. So when you want to convert the string into the date object, you need to put the month first and then day. Or you can use string split. You can use string split to assign DMY for represent date, month, and year, and then you can use DMY to create a date object. Another function for selecting the data in the list that is the select function. Specific function will be useful for you to select the data that you need by give the condition to the select function. You can see that the his data I have. I need to search the product ID is 1. So you can select his data, and then the second parameter will be start from chart. The chart will represent the his data, and then I use the association, so I buy the product ID with product key. So I use the key product to query the his data with the product ID. And then given the condition and followed by ampersand, it will to apply the list data to the chart. You can see that the output will be the record that product ID is 1. If you use the list, normal list, and I use his data, I use the association for representing the list, and normally you use the table the normal list to represent the his log, history log. So this is his table that I made from the his data. You can use the select table and use chart, then you must use the format of the in array. So you need to use blanket. You want to search second column, so you put the second column. And you can change the product ID, and it will select the list that contains the product ID is 2. To get input, what type of input? You mean the data from Excel file, or you mean the input from the input field? To get input from the user. For example, the demand I enter 25, the demand I declare the control type is input field. this level of the input field that will show you in the left side of the input field. And the variable demand that is like blue color. And this is the initial value of the demand variable. You can declare the input field like this. Input field will be by this the demand variable. When the user input the data in the input field, for example, I enter the 25 in the in demand input field, then the demand variable will be 25. And you can send the demand variable into another function. In my code, I use button add. You can see that the button add that I declare is the data variable. Yeah, I think I will start again and I show you how to use the manipulator to show the data